was all business.
Oh, well, all business at first, but there was still a lot of...
the sparks flew.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. They're still flying. Hi, guys. I'm Rebekah.
And I'm Stefan.
Hey, guys. I'm Tim.
And I'm Mischa.
Hi, I'm Alan.
I'm Georgie.
And we're both going to be reacting to some of Neighbours' very iconic moments, so watch out.
So exciting.
Oh, I never, ever saw that episode.
Who's that's Bouncer.
That's Bouncer. That's Bouncer's dream.
Who's the other doggy?
Yeah.
Is that his girlfriend?
I feel like I'm a Gogglebox.
Is that his girlfriend?
Hey.
Very cute. Yeah, well, neither of us were there that day.
I think that was Davey.
Is this a boxer's dream sequence?
It's one of my favourite episodes, I have to say, because it's just completely nuts.
Well, it's adorable. More of that, please.
Yes, yes.
I would have loved to be in the writer's room on that day when they came up with that. That one is pretty bizarre.
It's right out there.
I mean, my personal favourite storyline ever is Susan slipping on spilt milk. And then getting amnesia and thinking that she was a teenager.
Yeah.
I don't think anything can beat that for me.
When they had Little Britain on the show, because it suddenly broke out of Neighbours for about 30 seconds or so. But yeah, it was really weird because they came on and they were actually visiting and they managed to, they wanted to be on the show. And so their people spoke to our people and they ended up coming on and doing a little cameo.
The scene where Toadie drives off the cliff with his wife and the car crashes into the pond, that was quite outrageous, but I actually quite liked. There was one scene where Therese falls off the roof of Lassiter's. I think she's drunk and she tumbles and she's clinging onto this thing and Paul comes to her rescue. But, I mean, every moment is outrageous. So, I don't know, we'll be here for days if we talk about it.
Yeah.
That's the confetti.
Ah, oh, look at that. God,
oh.
Yeah.
Oh, that day was really...
cold.
Well, some of it
really
was
cold.
Shot.
It was indeed, and... we always have to make it look sunny and hot in Erinsborough, so we were all freezing with hot water bottles and big kind of robes on, and as soon as it'd say action, we would just throw it to the side and...
Well...
Yeah.
No, well, all the stuff with Kylie and Jason was shot weeks
ahead. 2 weeks, 2 weeks before. So all the stuff you see on the balcony, that was shot 2 weeks before.
And it was all sort of edited together.
And then put together, and with the streamers, because we had no streamers or anything, no sparkly stuff coming
out. But all of our stuff on the street, the fair kind of thing.
Because it involved, there's a final shot at the end where the drone shot where it pulls out and it shows, and it was brilliant for us, but brilliant for the audience as well, because it wasn't just the cast of Neighbours, it was the cast and the crew and the caterers and the administration.
Did they keep that in? I can't remember.
Yeah.
Where at the very end, all the crew walked in. Oh, it was beautiful.
And it was just such a lovely moment, but it was freezing.
I mean, it was such a harrowing kind of emotional time. I thought it was wrapped up beautifully. I thought they did a great way of wrapping it up for what we thought was the end.
Completely humiliated!
Please, don't you dare! Wait for it.
You must have so little respect for me if you could just lie and cheat!
Incredible day. Probably the biggest moment about that day, Jackie's happy to talk about this, is that she, you saw how wound up she was, right? This incredible performance.
Mm.
She was gripping her hand so tight that her nail cut her skin a little bit.
Oh, my God.
So she was bleeding a bit. So when she put her hand up to her face like this, took it down again, it left a little deposit of blood on her forehead. And we almost had to shoot the scene again because it was noted by the continuity people. And they said, oh, hang on. But the director said, there's no way. It's fine. So if you really want to zoom in on that image, you might find that little tiny morsel.
That is incredible.
And I saw it. I could see it, and I thought that she was she'd injured herself. And so my reaction to Susan screaming at Carl was more of it was like Alan going, "Are you okay?" But of course, that reaction turned out to be the best one anyway.
It would have been really cool. I mean, I know that it's like a fake slap, but it would have kind of been cooler if it was a real slap. Then the blood to like ended up on your.
Well,
face.
No, Jackie says that when she did the slap. In fact, from her hand, there was actually a spray.
Oh, wow.
So it was kind of an incredibly dramatic moment.
That's incredible. You both killed that.
It was an incredible scene. Once we'd finished filming the scene, we then took a still photograph. All the crew lined up behind Jackie to all take a slap at Carl.
No, he promised me.
Oh, maggot. Look at her.
He would be home for us, but you know. He went to all this trouble.
I'm a massive fan of Margot Robbie. I'm obsessed with her. She's such an incredible actress. And I remember when I got the job on Neighbours, going back and watching Neighbours episodes to prepare, and I watched a lot of her and that episode as well. She's incredible. Mm. She's absolutely amazing.
Jackie and I knew that Margot was exceptional from the first moment she walked onto the set.
I loved Barbie. You haven't even seen it. You wouldn't have seen it. I loved Barbie, but I love her. She's amazing.
It's a testament to the work, the hard work that we have to do on Neighbours and the experience it gives you, and you just have to have the ability to get on set and hit your mark and, I don't know.
Yeah, it's hard. It's hard work.
Everyone has always said how wonderful, gorgeous, down to earth and so talented and such an amazing person.
But she was exceptional at comedy as well, and she could swing between the two, which is a hallmark of Neighbours, of course. Mm. Neighbours has the light touch and has highly dramatic. So to have an actor who can do that, and now, of course, that she's enjoying this incredible success with Barbie, you've just got to sit there and go all hail to her. She's remarkable.
There were two people who, in my career in Neighbours, two people who stood out as far as just being completely and utterly enveloped in their character. One of them was Vicky Clark Blanche, who played my sister Julie in the show, the original Julie, not the second Julie.
And Margot.
Yeah, because they used to do. I'd be staggered. I write a couple of things on my script and, you know, highlight my lines and all that little note there. And that. Whereas they would do pages of notes for every scene. And I was like, oh my
God. But all
God,
the young kids, they still do that.
Do they? Anyway.
Actually,
but she
Ryan. Ryan.
Hmm? Ryan does that a bit, yeah. But honestly, when you saw Maggot stuff, she was like, you know, pages for each scene.
You and I don't do anything. We're just like,
The Neighbours is the best training ground in existence. In fact, Greta Gerwig did say that, you know, she was always astounded at Margot Robbie's ability to understand how the set worked and understand every aspect of the filming.
I'm still in love with you.
Oh, that's us. Oh, aren't we cute?
You rejected me last night.
Why did you reject me last night?
I still love you, darling.
I still love you.
Very emotional scene, because you've got to remember two things were going on. We were doing this very emotional scene of the two of us finally coming together and realizing that with what was my thing? You're it for me, something like that. But it was also we were saying goodbye to each other in the show, so it was a very, you know, and so that actually added to the scene for us as actors. Yeah. I really didn't have anything to do with you apart from the fact that you were a business colleague. But you were married to, well, not you, but you were married to Brad Willis.
Yeah, but it was all about you and me. It always has been about Therese and Paul.
But it was business at first. But it was all business.
Oh, it was business at first, but there was still a lot of...
But the sparks flew. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. They're still flying.
Development.
What's happening here? Oh, is it just, this is a compilation of people throwing food and drinks at each other on the show.
Sheila!
Do something! Get all of you little
Reese is actually a lot spicier than I was intending. I really thought she was going to be, it turns out. She's like, you know, the new drama that's going to irritate and get under Paul's skin and kind of, you know, shake things up in that front. And we all know how protective Paul's character is of his money and his things. So there's a lot of that. And then, you know, the love interest stuff is a lot steamier than I thought it was going to be. So there's that too.
Well, what the writers have done has been very clever, because we're starting the show again. It means that there's a 2-year break so that they can create a block of story that will astound the audience, because I like to say it's a marathon, not a sprint. We know what happens in the first episode, we know the twists, we know the turns, but the way it develops is so brilliant. And so, you know, it's almost like a thriller. So people, I'm going to encourage people to say, stay the journey with us. You're going to love it. It's going to looks amazing as well. And yeah.
I mean, we wouldn't be here without the fans. And I think a lot of us, after grieving the end of the show, went back for the fans, and we really felt the love, especially when it ended. So I think it's all for the fans, and I'm so excited to see how they feel about the revamp and the launch. So we're so grateful for the fans, and especially being here in the UK and really feeling it. It's been incredible.
Hey guys, thank you so much for watching the most iconic moments of Neighbours.
Your reaction's better than mine.
Thank you for watching us react to some of Neighbours' most iconic moments.
Make sure you tune in to watch us in the new chapter.
Keep watching.
Tune in for our next chapter.